On the road to glory, there always comes the ultimate battle. And this is it. This is the final hurdle. And the unwavering passion of these champions has brought them here, to the world's most famous off-road race. This competition is about to begin, and the victorious will have their names engraved in history. All the time, practice, sweat, and tears comes down to this. Bud Light Score International Baja 1000. And it starts now.
Hello, race fans, and welcome to beautiful Ensenada, Baja, California, for the 48th running of the Bud Light Score Baja 1000. I'm Jared Deanna, and with me is not only my co-host, third overall last year, and he's going to be jumping the saddle, Cameron Steele. Cameron, what's going through your mind, and how have you prepared for this iconic race?
Well, with decades of experience, the butterflies don't come as big as they used to, but you still have a lot of nervous anticipation as you get set for over 800 miles of battle with the Baja Peninsula. For us, we've had weeks of pre-running. My teammate, Pat Dean, has been down doing his work in his section. But more importantly, we took the Baja 500 off because it was so important to us to have a new motor package and make some chassis adjustments. This is what counts for the year. If you sat in the garage all year long and didn't race anything and won this race, your sponsors would be giving you a thumbs up, no problem, and they'd be beating on your door to come give you more money.
Well, 800 plus miles, 200 plus drivers, many different classes. Cam's gonna jump behind the wheel. The green flag is about to drop here at the iconic race that is the Baja 1000. Cameron, I'm going to talk about it, but you're going to be about it. You start ninth overall in the number 16 truck, and like we said, the preparation, the stories, that's what really pushes the Baja 1000 from iconic status to infamous status here at the Baja 1000.
The trophy trucks were still getting prepped for the race. The Pro Moto class kicked off this Baja 1000 early in the morning. Moto well on their way, Raul Hernandez in 14X is currently leading the way. The stage is set here in Ensenada, Mexico, as a year full of battles, misfortunes, and victories have all led to this. The Bud Light Score Baja 1000. Ricky Johnson starts it off for Justin Matney in the number 4 truck as the trophy trucks take the lead of the four-wheeled vehicles as they embark on this estimated 840-mile battle against the Baja terrain and each other for the coveted Score Championship.
Fastest areas for me on course is going to be the slick, hard turns where it's really kind of slower sections so I can drive and squirt out of the corners. I can't come into the corners turns any faster than the two-wheel drives, but I can roll and accelerate, get on the gas sooner to get off so I'm not so sideways. So that's where the four-wheel drive can save energy by not driving so hard and so sideways through the turns.
Tavo Vildosola starts in the second position as he and his team aim to lock down the year and become the first Mexican national team to be crowned champion.
Our fastest area is definitely going to be the beach section. It's off the start, it's during the day, you can see for miles. There's going to be a lot of fans out there. It's just going to be, you know, the energy's going to be crazy. So it'll be the start of the Baja 1000. So we expect that to be a quite fast section, probably averaging over 70 miles an hour.
Bryce Menzies in truck 70 starts in the third position, more than ready to conquer this terrain once again. The reigning Baja 1000 champion, Rob McCaffrey, in truck 11, starts off in fourth position. Off-road veteran Robbie Gordon in truck 77 going off the line in the fifth position.
Well, we've got a couple silt-bed sections. We got one on the coast. You know, for the trucks, it's really not that big of a deal. It's a really big deal for the lower classes. Obviously, if you just stay on line just a little bit, and you can get through them. But if you stop or you have a car in front of you, that's when you end up getting stuck in the silt. You know, the biggest thing is surviving Baja. We led the thing for 800 miles last year, broke a rear gear around 840, and obviously came up a little bit short. If we can keep that gear alive for 840 miles, we should be fine.
Rounding out the top six trophy trucks off the start line is Abdali Lopez in truck number 5, one of 4 teams fighting for the Score Points Championship today. Shelby Reed in buggy 168 takes the green flag as she leads the Class 1 buggies today, hoping to become the first woman to take the Score Points Championship for Class 1. Leading the charge for the trophy truck spec class is Pete Sorin in 862. Cody Reed in 1068 leads the Class 10 buggies off the line today. Leading the Class 19 UTVs is Benjamin Wilson in 1927. Even though the first opponent is Baja itself, these racers are primed and ready to do battle against each other, and victory is the only goal. And this year's competition has been intense. Leading in points and placing second at this year's SEMA qualifying, Tavo Vildosola is in the perfect position to podium at the Baja 1000, and doing so, become the first Mexican national to take the Score Points Championship. Second in points and placing in the top 10 at SEMA qualifying, Lalo Laguna is making quite a name for himself in his rookie year of trophy truck racing. And nothing would finish this year better than another win here today. Abdali Lopez and his veteran racer father Juan Carlos in the number 5 truck are sitting in third and are unrelenting in their fight for first place. They also stand a chance of becoming the first Mexican national team to take the Score Points Championship. The one racer that stands in their way is last year's Baja 1000 winner, Rob McCaffrey. Rob is teaming up with Andy McMillan again and has his sights set on repeating his championship. But a team that everyone has to look out for is RPM's number 4 trophy truck, driven by Ricky Johnson and Justin Matney. Ricky Johnson has been racing both two- and four-wheel vehicles for over 30 years, and his strong driving skills gave the team top finishing at SEMA qualifying. They are sure to continue a strong showing.
Ricky Johnson is flying as he leads the pack through Ojos Negros. Right behind him is Tavel Vildósola and Bryce Menzies. But this is just the beginning as we take a closer look at this grueling 821-mile race course.
For this year's Baja 1000, the racers will battle in an estimated 840 miles of rugged terrain, which all starts in Ensenada and then heads out into the hills of Ojos Negros. They will then head out into one of the tougher, tighter, and siltier sections of the early race, which takes them to Uruapan and Santo Tomas. From there, they will race down the Pacific coast through some of the more traditional routes we've all come to know. The racers are then going to jog up into the hills of San Catin for a short back and forth until they reach Highway 1. Then on to El Rosario, where Mama Espinosa's, one of the first checkpoints in the Baja 1000, is located. They will continue south along Highway 1 and out onto some unforgiving silt beds coming across the highway just north of Catavina. They are then going to do what's known as the Catavina Loop, which is about 120 miles of absolute desolation. Silt beds, rocks, and tough terrain. As the racers come back to Highway 1, just below El Crucero, they'll start returning back to the north and into the Chapala Dry Lake bed and head over to what is an iconic location known as Coco's Corner. This is going to take them northbound along the Sea of Cortez. Normally a beautiful view, but it's going to be dark for most of the vehicles that are leading the race. This will bring the racers to Puerto Citos and the menacing 100 miles of whoops. We are talking sand, rocks, and pure nightmare for most of the classes, so it is key not to use up your equipment. Puerto Citos, San Felipe, and then north in town to Three Poles, making the left to Borrego, which takes them up to San Matias Pass. Here it is all whoops, and the decision maker for the race. If a racer can get to Puerto Citos in the top five and then get out cleanly at San Matias, they are in the mix to win the Baja 1000. Finishing up, racers go through Valley Trinidad and then up through what's known as Jamu, past the Kurt Caselli Memorial and back to the K-77 area, Ojos Negros, and through the back hills entering Ensenada for the finish. From the start line in Ensenada, our course winds through suburbs, into outlying areas that will soon be suburbs, and eventually into the wilds of the Baja Peninsula. As the racers make their way into the edge of the desert, first off the line, Ricky Johnson encounters all sorts of obstacles as he blazes the trail and maintains his early lead over Tavo Vildósola. With Bryce Menzies not far behind. Also in the mix are last year's winner, Rob McCachran, Baja legend Robbie Gordon, and Abdali Lopez in truck number 5. Like his countryman Abdali, Lalo Laguna has a chance to become the first Mexican national to take the SCORE overall points championship. And he's giving this season-ending race all he's got. The trophy truck class has the deepest field of competitors of all the classes in this year's Baja 1000. It includes last year's third place finisher, Cameron Steele, in the number 16 truck. Wife Heidi in truck 14, currently being driven by Cody Parkhouse. As well as the 2014 SCORE overall points champion, Steven Eugenio. Ryan Arciero currently driving for Troy Herbst in truck 91. And Tim Herbst in truck 19. And and Chris Kemp in the 93 truck, who qualified with an impressive performance on the short track in Las Vegas. Competition like this makes clear that the desert terrain is only one of the challenges facing these drivers as they attempt to navigate the rugged course through the Baja Peninsula. The Pro Moto class is coming in at full speeds and is now being led by 45X Francisco Arredondo. For the lead position continues into the high country. Ricky Johnson's advantage looks increasingly precarious. Tavo breathes down his neck as they churn through boulder fields and mountain passes. Meanwhile, Bryce Menzies keeps pace in third position. And Rob McCachran tenaciously holds on to fourth. As Robbie Gordon lurks over his shoulder. Cruising through the Baja scrubland, McCachran is forced onto a side trail by mechanical issues. This gives Robbie Gordon an opening, and he doesn't hesitate to seize it, assuming the fourth position on course. Overlooking the pristine waters of the Pacific Ocean, the fans are waiting with anticipation for their first glimpse of the Pro Moto class, in which 45X Francisco Arredondo is coming in strong through the rocky beach terrain. Starting all the way back in ninth, but now in the second position, is 5X Colton Udall. 14X Raul Hernandez was the first off the line, but currently has dropped to third, with 3X Mark Samuels right behind him. As each of the Pro Moto racers continues to fight through the course, they know that with the many obstacles Baja has to surprise you, anything can turn the tide out here. Just 39 miles from the start, the Class 1 pack is tight, with first position currently being held by Shelby Reed driving Buggy 168. Closing in fast is John Walker in car 189. In third position, we have Wilson Motorsports' Brian Wilson in car number 153. In class 10, Peter Ajas driving car 1080 is holding first position, followed by car 1045 driven by Travis Clark. Hot on his heels in third position is Arnaldo Gutierrez in car 1089. As Robbie Gordon races to make up ground on the leaders, Rob Mack pursues him with the single-minded focus that has made him a champion. Gustavo and Bryce Menzies continue to press Ricky Johnson as the racers head toward the beach. Before them looms a great bank of coastal fog. It's a development that could reduce their visibility on the course to almost zero. In these conditions, there's no telling what the drivers might encounter in their path. Superstar Ryan Viapato announced his retirement from motocross this year. He never thought he'd end up behind the wheel of a trophy truck spec and racing in the most extreme off-road race in the world, the Baja 1000. But when Jonathan and Jordan Brenthel of Brenthel Industries called and asked him to help out on driving duties on their 873 truck, he couldn't resist the opportunity.
Well, I got the call to come down and check out Baja 1000 with the Brenthel crew, and well, I guess you just jump into the deep end and go for it.
Someone with his kind of experience and being a four-time AMA Supercross champion, someone that races and has that kind of mindset and training is someone that we felt could be really good on the team.
It's a total different scenario. It's a different atmosphere. Right now, this is my first experience down here in the Baja. But I don't plan on just getting passed by everybody. Like, that's not why we race.
After conquering the fog, leader Tavo Vildosola emerges unscathed with the Pacific Ocean in sight. And more importantly, Ricky Johnson in his rear view. The top qualifier encountered some mechanical issues, and Tavo was in position to take the lead. But Bryce Menzies is matching him step for step, mile for mile. Their duel stretches out along the spectacular coastline, but these warriors aren't out for a scenic drive. They're far from alone out here. There's a crowd of drivers in their dust, ready to take them down. Billy Wilson, driving 884, is currently leading in first position of the trophy truck spec class. followed closely by Jordan Brentel driving truck 872. In third position is Cops Racing Truck 878, driven by John Langley. Leading the Class 19 UTVs is Wes Miller in 1988. Not too far behind him in second position is 1921 Johnny Angel. Currently in third position is 1949, driven by Alonzo Lopez. Tavo Vildosola is maintaining his position as first on course, with Bryce Menzies in pursuit. Trying to catch up, the rest of the field has their work cut out for them. But Robbie Gordon is still pressing the leaders, and Abdali Lopez has overtaken Rob McCaquin to claim fourth position. Cameron Steele is also running strong, but the drivers behind him will not let him get complacent. Here on the coast is mostly flat, so the drivers have a chance to open the throttle wide and let the horses run. With the 45X bike going down, the team of 5X Colton Udall takes over the top position. After crashing, 45X Shane Esposito quickly gets back on his bike and tries to regain the lead. Meanwhile, the rest of the Pro Moto class continue to give chase on the leaders. Trophy trucks have conquered the beach and now turn inland. The order of the racers holds steady. Tavo Vildosola is first on course. Bryce Menzies follows him. Gordon in the 77 truck continues to hold a spot in the top three. And Abdali Lopez still has his eye on the prize. Defending Baja 1000 champion Rob McCaughrin looks for the opportunity to make his move. Many outposts on the route through the peninsula is the B.F. Goodrich Pit in Colonnette. For the drivers who need service, it's a welcome sight. And as the trophy trucks reach this point, one of the drivers who takes advantage is our leader, Tavo Vildosola. Tavo's pause gives Bryce Menzies the opening he's been looking for. And just like that, we have a new leader. In the fight, Bryce Menzies is making the most of the turn of events that finds him blazing along in first position. But Tavo didn't become one of the top names in off-road racing by giving up easily. And one by one, the rest of the field follows, charging uphill into the dust, no one backing off an inch. The 48th Baja 1000 saw top qualifier in the trophy trucks, Ricky Johnson, hold an early lead against repeated challenges from Tavo Vildosola. By the time the drivers got to the coast, mechanical issues had taken down Ricky, and Tavo took over first position. He held it through the entire length of the coastal section until Bryce Menzies passed him during a pit stop at Colonnette. The Tavo-Bryce battle has been epic, but there's a lot of Baja yet to be conquered. Still in the hunt are Robbie Gordon, Abdali Lopez, and last year's winner, Rob McCaughrin, rounding out the current top five. Schuler of Jagged X Racing started the season determined to take the 2015 SCORE Championship in the UTV class, and he's well on his way to making that happen. Currently sitting in third in points, but only 3 points behind the leader, this is anyone's podium to take.
We race very conservative and make sure that we get to the finish line. These races that we're racing are not little short races. They're long distance, you know, in between 100 and 1,000 miles. And if you break your car in the first 200 miles, it doesn't matter how fast you were to get there. I would say the Baja 1000 is probably one of my favorite races. It has a little bit to do with the driver and the race car. It has a lot to do with what your team does. It's not just your pit crew, it's not just your car, it's everything combined. It's how you plan the race. In the ETV class, we definitely have to drive different than the other racers. Got a lot smaller tires, different suspension design. I would say the biggest part of it is line choice. You can't go into the big ruts. You have to avoid the silt beds. You don't have as much power, you don't have as much travel. So you just kind of pick and choose your way and hope that you don't choose the wrong line. If you start a race and you have a problem, you do not podium. So you gotta be in your A game at all time.
Running along the beach at race mile 100, Brian Wilson in 153 has moved up from third position to take the lead in class one. Still holding second position is John Walker in 189. Followed closely by Randy Wilson in 138. Leading class 10 is car 1068, driven by Cody Reed. Arnoldo Gutierrez in car 1089 has moved up from third and into second position. Now in third position is 1002, piloted by Steve Lawler. Jordan Brenthel in 872 has taken the lead in the trophy truck spec class. Now in second is Elias Hanna driving truck 874. Gunning for the 2015 SCORE Championship is Larry Connor driving truck 871. He is currently in the third position and closing in on the two leaders. Still leading the class 19 UTVs is Wes Miller in number 1988. Now followed by 1942, Scott McFarland in second. And car 1908, driven by Justin Lambert in third. Competition among the trophy trucks remains fierce as SCORE's marquee class heads into one of the silt beds. Silt beds pose a special challenge for drivers fighting for position. Engines and drivers could choke on the dust, so they're both fitted with filters. But when visibility is impaired, the only way to restore it is to shift out of the established track away from the dust cloud. Silt is definitely a challenge, but then the Baja 1000 is nothing but challenges, mile after mile of them. And these drivers are determined to overcome whatever the course throws at them. They may even have fun doing it. In the heat of battle, there's room enough on the course for every driver to give it his all. But there's only room on the top of the podium for one driver. Tavo Vildosima is determined to be that top driver. In the 2015 SCORE International Racing Series, the entire season has definitely belonged to the 33-year-old racer, Tavo Vildosima. After two first-place finishes, with one of those wins making history when he took first place overall for the third consecutive year at the San Felipe 250 2015. The number 21 truck has finished in the top five in all four races so far, and currently, Tavo has a 22-point lead over his second-place competition. After racing four of the five races, Tavo has completed every race mile and is up for a 2015 SCORE Milestone Award. Could Vildosima's 15th year in racing be the year he becomes the first Mexican national to take the overall SCORE points championship?
Ever since my dad bought his first trophy truck in 2002, that has been the goal, right? Be the first Mexican team to win 1,000. Last year we entered the Baja 1000 being defensive about our points. This time we need to go attack.
In the Pro Moto class, the 5X team of Colton Udall is proving why they are the team to beat. While the rest of the class tries their best to stay close. Very own Cameron Steele in Trophy Truck 16, currently making headway as he races down the Baja Peninsula. Cameron Steele is currently at race mile 326, and his wife Heidi's Trophy Truck 14 is at race mile 305. Let's find out more about this dynamic couple of the desert, the Steeles. Off-road racing as a family business is a very normal thing in Baja. Vildosima Racing, made up of father and son Gus and Tavo Vildosima, the family of McMillan Racing. But what makes the Desert Assassins team different is that it is comprised of husband and wife, Cameron and Heidi Steele.
The Baja 1000 is something that's been in the Steele family name since 1971. It's definitely cool to have my wife doing it.
Heidi Steele started racing a Class 7 truck in 2004, and after quite a few successful seasons, she moved up to trophy trucks and currently drives truck number 14.
It's pretty awesome that we're both racing and competing against each other.
I'm stoked to have Hunbun in the truck again at the 1,000. You know, it's a little bit nerve-wracking on one side, and on the other side, I'm very proud. My daughter's mom being out there in an 800 horsepower trophy truck.
Being a mom has definitely changed me. It's really hard mentally getting in the truck. Once I'm in the truck, it's fine. I'm completely focused on racing to win.
Cameron Steele has been racing for over 30 years and has many wins under his belt in motorcycles and trucks. When this couple isn't out tearing up the dirt, they're at home with their beautiful 3-year-old daughter, Kay.
Balancing everything along with our family and racing, the better off we are as a couple.
Driving truck 14 for Heidi Steele is Cody Parkhouse, who will then hand it off to his father, Brian Parkhouse, and finishing the race will be Heidi Steele. With the sun starting to go down, the locals are trying to stay clear from the incoming pro moto class that is blazing through the course. From a distance, we can see there is one team clearly in front and is separating themselves from the rest of the pack. And that team is 5X Colton Udall. Staying aggressive and still in the second spot is 45X Francisco Arredondo. And 1X Ricky Brabeck is in the third position. Since Mark Samuels is currently racing the 5X bike, Ray Del Soglio has taken over this leg for the 3X Ox Motorsports team. Sunlight is dwindling, and out on the course, headlights flash on to cut the dusk. But there's still a lot of racing to go. The race order remains stable. Bryce Menzies sets the pace. Tavo Vildosola on his tail. And Robbie Gordon running strong in third position. The parade of trophy trucks in the fading light makes a tremendous spectacle in the desert. As daylight grows short, drivers have to depend more and more on their running lights. Until finally, headlights are the only illumination on the course. At race mile 275, the change from day to night hasn't affected Brian Wilson, who still holds first position in class one. Pushing to catch the leader is car 189, driven by John Walker. Randy Wilson, driving 138, also continues to hold third position. In class 10, Arnaldo Gutierrez in car 1089 has taken the lead from Cody Reed, who is now in second position. And back in the top three, Travis Clark charges off into the darkness in car 1045. After taking over for 5X Colton Udall, fellow Ox Motorsports teammate Mark Samuels rode it through the first part of the night and is about to hand it back to Colton to bring it home to the finish line.
I got on at Catavina and just got off. It got a little darker than we expected, so. And we had the front light. The front light go out. I ended up clipping a rock and went down pretty good. Hit my head a little bit, but I was all right. I got back up, put the bar straight, and salvaged the light what I could. And then we fixed it and I rode her in, and everything was fine. We just took it apart and put the new ones on, and his lights were ready to rock. So now it's into the nighttime, San Felipe. A few more hundred miles to go. Let's see how it goes.
With Colton Udall now in the lead, the rest of the Pro Moto class is spread throughout the course in the pitch black darkness of Baja, just trying to stay close and finish the race safely.
Well, we're moments away from seeing our first vehicle cross the finish line here at the 48th running of the Baja 1000, and it's in the Pro Moto class. Colton Udall on the 5X bike talked earlier this season about earning back that 1X number plate. Looks like that is about to become a reality.
The dedication and hard work throughout the year have paid off for the Ox Motorsports team of 5X Colton Udall and 3X Mark Samuels. Even though the competition was more fierce than last year with the 1X team of Ricky Brabeck, it doesn't take away the skills and determination these guys bring in and day out to the sport of off-road racing.
I started off, ninth off the starting line, and Mark actually was on his bike third, and I just kept pushing away and got by a bunch of guys, except I think the Shane Esposito 45X guy, and then Justin passed him, and I think when he crashed, and since then we've been leading ever since. Our pits, we nailed them, we hung our lights perfectly, like everything went really, really good, and surprisingly, any issue we had, we patched it up really well. So it feels amazing, you know. Taking back 1X is a lot of hard work, and our team is all year has been working super hard to get this done. And it feels amazing to be here at the finish line of the 2015 Baja 1000 and with a giant time gap. So stoked.
Next across the line is Shane Esposito with the 45X team of Francisco Arredondo and Ryan Penhall.
It was good for the most part. I was in the lead physically and went down at 195, and that's when 5X got around us.
And finally, last year's overall winner, the 1X team of Ricky Brabeck, crosses the line again in the top three.
The race was good. We rode a real clean race, and the bike never hit the ground, and didn't end up with the result we wanted to, but it was a lot of fun, and I learned a lot, and it was great. Yeah.
Now, with their Ox Motorsports 3X teammate crossing the finish line, no one can doubt this team is definitely a force to be reckoned with. And have stamped their names into the history books alongside the other top winners of the Baja 1000.
Well, as you can see, the sun has set, the blue skies are gone, and fog has rolled in. This could wreak havoc on the drivers that are still on the Pacific coast. And currently, in Trophy Truck Spec Class,
Jordan Brenthel in 872 continues to hold on to the lead in the Trophy Truck Spec Class. But coming up fast is Larry Connor in Truck 871. He has now taken the second position from Truck 874, who has dropped back to fourth. Billy Wilson in 884 has made his way back up with the leaders, where he now sits in third position. Also making a comeback is Johnny Angel in 1921, who made his way up to first position in the Class 19 UTVs. Still maintaining his position in second is Scott McFarland, driving 1943. Wes Miller in 1988 has dropped back from first, but is still running strong in third position.
Currently in Trophy Truck Spec, Jonathan Brenthal in the 873 is in the lead, and right behind him is Larry Connor in 871, who's going for another Trophy Truck Spec championship.
With only a few years of racing Trophy Truck Spec, Larry Connor has had a run of victories, including winning last year's Baja 1000 in his class and the Season Points Championship.
I've done a lot of pavement racing, formula cars, sports cars, things like that. Came down here like a lot of other people to just sample Baja, fell in love with it. And then last year we formed our own team, Team C Racing. So this is our second year. We work so hard on our preparation before the race. We've got a really good team. What we tell everybody on the team, hey, just do your job, be relaxed, in control, and things will work out. So you want to focus on the things that you can control. Keep it simple, just more on the process and the outcome. You know, if your mind's on the prize, you'll forget about the process. You gotta set a pace, you gotta be disciplined enough to just stick to the pace and believe that what you've done will get you home.
Larry and his 871 truck have completely dominated their class this year, winning every race. And now he's focused on repeating his win from the Baja 1000 in 2014. Jesse Jones has taken over driving duties as Truck 70 still leads the pack. Not far behind is Juan Carlos Lopez, who has also taken over Abdali in the number 5 truck. In the third position is Andy McMillan, now driving for Rob McCachran in Truck 11. Just as the team in Truck 70 begins to settle in as leaders, Jesse Jones feels something is wrong with the truck.
Does anybody copy Jesse? We're broke down in San Felipe, approximately race mile 642.
We need a rack.
We're gonna need a rack out here for the steering.
The team has lost the steering, putting their comfortable lead in jeopardy, and most importantly, their race, as Juan Carlos Lopez is the first to pass them and takes the lead of the trophy trucks.
Well, the party unfolds for our top three pro moto finishers that cross the finish line first. But now it's time for our trophy truck update. As Bryce Menzies leads the pack, Intel Race Mile 600. He's broken on the side of the road and evidently is getting a part delivered to him. We'll see how much time he needs to make up as he gets passed by who was second and third. Abdali Lopez and Rob Mack are now in first and second.
The action is still heating up as the trophy trucks are on a dash to the finish line and are pushing their trucks to the limit. Juan Carlos Lopez in truck number 5 is still leading the trophy trucks. Very close behind is Andy McMillan in truck 11, in for Rob McCachran and relentless in his pursuit for a repeat win here today. Lalo Laguna in truck 17 is still staying close to the leaders. Troy Herbst in truck 91 has climbed from an 18th starting position and currently sits in fourth without any signs of slowing down. Not far behind Troy is his teammate Tim Herbst in truck 19, who has also made great progress after starting in the 23rd position. Brian Parkhouse, currently behind the wheel for truck 14, is getting ready to hand over the truck to Heidi Steele, who will take it the rest of the way to the finish line.
Rob McCachran, simply known as Rob Mack to his fans. He won Baja 1000 last year. Can he repeat? Well, let's find out more about this Hall of Fame driver.
With almost 30 years of SCORE off-road desert racing under his belt, 3 San Felipe 250 wins, 1 Baja 500 win, and aggressively working on his 3rd Baja 1000 win, Rob McCachran is already a champion. The hard work and preparation he has put in leading up to the race have him in a great position to take that checkered flag.
This could be a very special Baja 1000. We feel we have a great plan.
This is the 3rd year Rob Mack has chosen Andy McMillan, a 4-time Baja 1000 trophy truck winner, to take on this challenge with him. Andy comes from a long line of off-road racers, and his speed and technique complement Rob in every way. Their first Baja 1000 together in 2013 had them finishing in a disappointing 2nd. But in 2014, they took the knowledge they gained and dominated, taking the top spot on the podium. Rob's 2015 season started out a little rocky, but after a 3rd place finish at Baja Sur 500 and a 2nd place finish at the Baja 500, Rob Mack is prepared and ready to go, sitting in 4th in the points race. Taking a 2nd consecutive win at the Baja 1000 would prove that Rob Mack is truly the king of off-road racing. John Walker in car 189 has taken the lead in class one from Brian Wilson. Having led the race earlier in the day, Shelby Reed in car 168 has worked her way back and into second place. Victor Barrera, driving car 160, has taken over third position from Randy Wilson in 138, who has fallen back with mechanical issues. In class 10, there is a battle for first as Cody Reed has retaken the lead from Arnaldo Gutierrez and has a good chance at first place if he can hold him off. Having moved his way up through the field, Morgan Langley in car 1011 is now in third and poses a threat to the top two drivers ahead of him. In the trophy truck spec class, the battle for first has also heated up as Larry Connor in 871 has captured the lead from Jordan Brenthel, who has dropped back with mechanical issues. New to the fight for first is truck 862, driven by Pete Sorin, who is currently holding second place. Also battling for position is truck 845, driven by William Hedrick, currently in third position. Leading class 19 UTVs is Terry Hui, driving 1971, followed closely by Dan Fresh in car 1939. Not too far behind, Scott McFarland is still in, but has dropped back to third position. Steele takes over driving duties for truck 14 as the team prepares for the final stretch of this Bud Light Baja 1000. The trophy trucks are now battling in total darkness in the Baja desert. After the unfortunate breakdown of truck 70, Juan Carlos Lopez leads the pack. And with a repeat win just within arm's reach, Andy McMillan in truck 11 looks to stop at nothing to achieve the victory for his team. Thank you.
Well, we're nearing the 3 a.m. dial here in Ensenada where it all began. Who's going to cross the finish line first? Right now, if it ended, Abdali Lopez, who's going for his first ever Baja 1000 victory, his first ever SCORE World Desert Championship, who would also be the first Mexican national to hold that title. But don't count out Rob Mack, Rob McCachran, the most winningest off-road truck racer in history. It's all going down here in Ensenada in the Baja 1000. Who's going to see the checkered flag first?
We're in the middle of the night as anxious fans wait for the arrival of their favorite racers. The trophy trucks will now begin making their way into Ensenada and start winding down this 2015 Bud Light Baja 1000. And the father-son team of Abdali Lopez and Juan Carlos Lopez in the number 5 truck are the first to cross the finish line at a total time of 16 hours, 14 minutes, and 54 seconds. Crossing the finish line in the second position is the team of Rob McCachran and Andy McMillan. Even though they weren't first to cross the line, with a total time of 15 hours, 58 minutes, and 32 seconds, the team once again take the flag and become back-to-back champions in this Baja 1000.
So I was pushing really hard. The truck held up, you know, more than I could probably ask from it. I was really, really giving it my all. Every gear hitting the rev limiter, just really driving as hard as I could. And my dad said while we were out there, he says, don't give up. You never know what can happen before you get to the finish line. You still got a long way to go. And here we are at the finish, and it looks like he was right. Me and Rob, such a dynamic team, is our complementary driving styles. We're both very similar behind the wheel. Brady rode with him at Vegas Torino and kind of told me kind of what Rob does and how we're very similar. Rob has a tremendous team of professionals at his race shop that prep this truck and get it ready for the races, and a tremendous support team with the Baja Fools out there pitting for us. And it makes all the difference, you know. I get in this truck and I feel like I'm next to invincible. You know, you're not always 100% invincible, but I feel like if I need to push, I can push, and the truck will always, you know, have the tires underneath me and get me to the finish line.
In 2013, Baja 1000, I knew it was a long course, gonna be tough, difficult, and I started thinking, who would I wanna have drive with me? And, you know, quickly came to mind Andy McMillan. You know, he's younger than I am, but he's just as wise as I am. The McMillan group has had, their whole family. There's so much rich history there. All that knowledge has been passed on to him and his cousins, Luke and Dan. And, you know, I knew that he'd be a great guy to teammate with. And he would drive, you know, do what it takes to win, not do too much, and be smart about it. Two Baja 1000s in a row, second the one before that. And I know my guys know how to prep the truck. You got to surround yourself with the right people. And, you know, on my team, the McMillan team, you know, our sponsors, Rockstar Energy, BF Finish Tires, Makita Tools, you know, all the people that are on this truck, you know, we're doing it for them, trying to win races, and, you know, here we are. It's a really good feeling. Winning the Baja 1000 is like no other feeling in the world. When you win this race, you know you accomplished something. And again, this Baja 1000 was incredibly tough. The dust that was out there was hanging in my section up to mile 477 was incredible. And I was a lot of stress going on for me, trying not to get stuck and stay clear of everything. But everything went well, and we're here. We're happy.
With a second place finish here today, Abdali Lopez and the number 5 truck become the official overall SCORE points champions for 2015, making them the first Mexican team to take the championship in the trophy truck class.
Pues es un sueño hecho realidad. No tengo palabras para describirlo.
Pues nos sentimos muy orgullosos. Yo creo que no hay palabras, no, y agradecerle a todo el equipo, más que nada, primeramente a Dios, que nos dejó terminar esta carrera con bien. Y pues a todo el equipo RPM, PIN, y a todos los amigos y toda la afición que nos está apoyando, y es algo esperado, ¿no?, por varios años, y pues se logró, gracias a Dios. Entre Carlos y yo y los copilotos, pues se logró esta carrera y el campeonato, como está todo.
Hemos tenido un grandioso año con RPM, con Lalo, yo y esta vez en la Baja 1000 con mi papá. Creo que vamos a seguir continuando con los excelentes resultados. quiero agradecer a mi papá principalmente por ayudarme a manejar y a lograr esto, a Clyde Stacy, Justin Madley, RPM Offroad y a todos los patrocinadores que hacen esto posible.
No, pues me siento muy orgulloso de Carlos, creo que ya superó al maestro, ¿no? Y es lo que uno quiere, que los hijos pues lo superen en todo a uno, ¿no? Que todo lo que les enseña uno de bien, lo agarren y pues aquí están los resultados de él ya también.
As the top finishers in the trophy truck class are celebrating, the rest of the trophy truck class begins to make their way to the finish line in this Bud Light Baja 1000. And finishing in third place is the RPM truck of Lalo Laguna with a total time of 16 hours, 17 minutes, and 2 seconds.
I feel happy because it's the first overall championship in trophy truck class for Mexico. So honestly, it doesn't matter if it was Tavo, Abdali, or us. As long as we can keep it in Mexico, I'm happy with it. And could it be better with RPM? Number one plate, so it's gonna be cool.
Coming in fourth place are Troy Herbst and Ryan Arciero with a total time of 16 hours, 46 minutes, and 57 seconds.
Well, we started 18th off the line. We had a little bit of a bad qualifying, but he worked his way up to ninth. And then it's really tough to get around some of these other guys. If you can't pass the qualifying, they're just fast enough to hold you up. And he got held up in the dust for quite a long time, but gave me the car in about ninth place. And then we worked our just way up and just kept on pecking, but got a lot of dust. Tires did great, Monster Energy did fantastic. All the TurboWorks guys are excited. It's just 4:30 in the morning. We're a little disappointed we're fourth.
I think what killed us today is when the fog came in on the coast, we weren't expecting that at all. Made visibility really bad. And then all week long, we've had wind. And it's been fantastic. We had a little bit of rain and wind. Today, zero wind down south, even on the coast. And the dust was just hanging there. It really hindered some of the high-speed sections for us where we can really charge. We had to be patient, not to get stuck in the silt, kind of make our way through it. And, the truck itself ran fantastic. We gave up a little bit of time at the end, but, gave the truck to Troy in a good position. And I think we're fifth or sixth on the road at that point, and Troy did the rest from there.
Even before the trophy trucks got on their way, teams were already dealing with race challenges. Luke McMillan was waiting for his turn at the green flag when he realized that something was wrong under the hood. He alerted his team, and with the clock ticking, they sprang into action. Luke waited anxiously as the trucks ahead of him took the green flag and headed out on the course. Finally, with only seconds to go, Luke's mechanic and co-driver finished replacing a bad steering belt. And the 83 truck was ready to take on Baja. Tim Herbst in truck 19 comes in fifth place at a total time of 17 hours, 1 minute, and 12 seconds.
It was a pretty good day. Larry Rosser did a great job the first half of the race. He started the race fourth at truck 19, and we got in about halfway and ran pretty good and just popped a little bit of power steering on the last 150 miles, and other than that, had a great day.
Rounding out the top six trophy trucks is Tavo Vildosova, finishing at a total time of 17 hours, 7 minutes, and 45 seconds.
Yeah, rough day for me. The truck ran perfect. Absolutely no problems all day long, but I just had a couple of mental lapses. Got a couple of flats early. Bryce got by me, and then got stuck in the silt beds at 295. And, I was just talking about how you really, really need to make a mistake to get stuck, and we couldn't see anything. Went right into the silt bed, buried the rear end, and we lost about 45 minutes there, and that really just put us out of contention. We battled back, tried to do everything we could, but at that point it was too late, and just a little obviously very disappointed in this race, but congratulate, Abdali and his dad, Juan Carlos, for a great race.
Corey Kasar takes the checkered flag for John Walker and Buggy 189, coming in at a total time of 18 hours, 49 minutes, and 23 seconds.
The start was, of course, the class one, start behind everybody, the trophy trucks and stuff, so that was a lot of beating and banging for 100, 150 miles. It was fun.
These guys put us in a great position, and we just
we just kept working on it and eventually got in the lead and just maintained the lead the whole time and just kept building on it. I don't know how far ahead we are right now, but we just kept working on the lead and working on the lead, just trying to be consistent. So car worked great. The two guys before us did great. So John Walker and Kevin Sullivan, my co-driver Guy Aldrich, did a great job too. So.
Shelby Reed takes second place with a total time of 18 hours, 58 minutes, and 25 seconds.
The race went really well. The car did good. I think she's a little tired now, but Danny started the race and got out front pretty quick, and then he went to 285. His brother Dell Everts got in, and he went 285 to 575. That's when I got in the car at Portecitos to the finish. At that point, we were in the lead about 10 miles, 20 miles into my run. I hit a big old rock and wrapped the rim around the rotor, so we were there for a while. We got passed, and then it was just trying to play catch up, and then some of it, let's just get there to the finish, and we'll see how it pans out now.
Larry Connor and his team take the checkered flag for the Trophy Truck Spec Class with a total time of 18 hours, 33 minutes, and 23 seconds.
It was really a clean run. Neil Mason did a great job. These two guys did a phenomenal job, Jay and Sean. And our game plan at that point was just to turn the truck over to them in good shape and keep moving down the road. We started last year with the Baja 1000 win, and then this year we've been able to run off five in a row. But the real credit's got to go to all the guys on the team. It is a team deal. It's a people deal. Mason Motorsport truck was unbelievable. The prep that was done on the thing. I mean, we had virtually no problems through the entire season mechanically. And so, yeah, we're just very fortunate. But I do think it is a case of, you know, preparation and hard work, not just luck, as some people might think.
With a commanding lead in overall points and a first-place finish here today, Aaron Ampudia in Buggy 1636 takes the championship for Class 1-2-1600. Taking the Class 10 championship, Cody Reed in Buggy 1068 finishes with a total time of 20 hours, 55 minutes, and 16 seconds. Terry Huey takes the checkered flag for Class 19 UTV, coming in at a time of 21 hours, 59 minutes, and 59 seconds. Veteran Rob McCachran becomes the repeat Baja 1000 champion, taking the overall win here today with a total time of 15 hours, 58 minutes, and 32 seconds. Abdali Lopez in the number 5 truck took second, taking him to the top of the overall points leaderboard and crowning himself the first Mexican national to win the SCORE Points Championship. 5X Colton Udall won the championship for the Pro Moto class as he took the checkered flag at a total time of 16 hours, 29 minutes, and 8 seconds. Larry Connor in 871 takes the overall points championship for the Trophy Truck Spec class as he takes a win here with a time of 18 hours, 33 minutes, and 23 seconds. 1636 Aaron Ampudia takes the crown with a win here today for the 1-2-1600 class. And 1068 Cody Reed takes the points championship for Class 10 for 2015. With a second place finish, 1932 Brandon Schuler takes the championship for Class 19 UTVs, coming in at a time of 22 hours, 25 minutes, and 6 seconds.
Well, the sun has set yesterday, and it's risen again today. That's a wrap for the 48th running of the Baja 1000. We were sitting here nice and comfortable at home base, but a gentleman that was doing battle out in the desert, Cameron Steele, joins us once again. There's your microphone. How did this course compare to other years, and how did you navigate this treacherous course?
Tough and technical, I gotta tell you. I mean, everybody thinks it's gonna be 55, 60 miles an hour average, or even 65, but man, it really just shrinks down with the back and forth. And you know, you mix in the silt, which was a big difference maker for a lot of people here today. And it really comes back to the pre-running and being able to find ways around the tough stuff right at the last minute before the race starts. So, you know, for us, we're running in the front, running near the front. We were right in the mix all the way to race mile 630 and lost the power steering pump. But that's what happens when you push and push and push. Us, Bryce Menzie, Jesse Jones, within a mile of each other, same problem.
Yeah, it seemed to be a reoccurring theme for veterans and even rookies, but some rookies rose to the top. You know, La Laguna,
Abdali Lopez, some notable names, but Rob McCracken, obviously we'll see where the pieces fall, right?
Yeah, I mean, it's going to come down to after the fact. We're going to find out where the penalties are. There's VCPs, which you have to be within 120 feet of. So it's so tough because of the silt, like I said, and the variances. You really have to be on your game to make sure you hit all the marks, plus some of the speed zones through the towns, the pueblos, the villages. It just takes a lot to really nail a Baja 1000, and the dust won't be settled here at the finish line. It's going to be done by the computer.
Yeah, most definitely. And so many of the classes are still streaming in, but that's a wrap for here at the finish line of the 48th running of the Baja 1000.